Hello people, welcome to the channel and thank you for tuning in. It's been a while since I motor vlogged. Finally I'm back, out on a breakfast ride. Time is 7:39. It's the 5th of April 2024. I've come on a different bike. It's not what I ride every day. We got two bikes today actually. One is this, the Royal Enfield Himalayan 450. And the other one is going to be the Triumph Scrambler 400. So, what we've done is, okay, let me just keep this here first. So, this is not a paid promotion. We booked the bikes, paid for them for 24 hours. We picked it up last evening, had some small city ride. So, decided to go for a breakfast ride. I'm on the Bangalore Highway. Santosh is riding the Scrambler 400 and we have Sunil, Santosh's brother. We've seen him in one or two of my videos. He's come by the Tata Tiago EV. I will not go into all the technical details about the length of the motorcycle or the height of the motorcycle and all that. This is basic. There are so many videos about all these technical details. Inox windshield, inch-span riding boots. But it's all this is just lying on home idle. Need to use it once in a while. All the money invested in riding gear is going waste. A nice round LED. I'm not used to all this new switch gear. So, to talk about the motorcycle, first impressions after riding, I'll tell you how much. About 67.7 kilometers. I didn't pull the throttle down completely as we have speed limits. I rented this bike from Royal Brothers and I think they do monitor all this. I did about 120, I was doing this, is showing 114. It's easy, the seat is really nice, it's comfortable, the seating posture, handle, it's all good. The best part that I liked about this motorcycle is the gearbox. It's so smooth. The butter smooth gearbox, I don't know. The vehicle has done about 9,500 kilometers, has been used, it's not new. Riding in 6th gear, you keep it at around 6,000 RPM. You can easily cruise at 120, 115. Doing triple digit speeds is not that difficult. You can effortlessly do it. With minimal vibrations, that is always there. It is not that it is vibration free, I won't say that. But it's manageable. I think that's because I've been riding Royal Enfields for the last 10 to 12 years. I've gotten used to the vibrations and this is actually excellent for the vibrations that you have on the older generation motorcycles. Very well refined, I would say. And you don't have to shift between gears. When you're in 6th gear, you can come all the way down until 55. I ride 55, I'll try showing it to you. So it'll come down up to 2,500 RPM and then you can still go ahead, throttle, and you're on your way. Highways, you don't have to shift between gears to overtake. It's got the power, it's got the comfort, and it's got the tech as well. It's completely digital instrument cluster with a USB C type charging socket. There's no mobile holder. Once we stop, I will show you how we connect into the navigator. I mean, what is this called? This is called a tripper meter. A tripper navigator, I think. There's some name for it. Okay, the suspension is nice, it's soft. Not so hard. This bike is not so well maintained, so. You know, rental bikes. Just to get the experience. What else? What is it I find interesting on this motorcycle? Fuel tank capacity. Pretty decent mileage also, I guess. It was showing somewhere. I still have a range of 254 kilometers. Fuel consumption, that is instantaneous. It keeps changing as per acceleration. You get battery voltage. This vehicle is overdue its service. Royal Brothers, if you're watching, please look into this. These mirrors are different. This is the actual Himalayan 452's rear mirrors. I think someone has broken it and they've replaced it with the old Himalayan 411 mirror. So that's our Tiago EV. The Scrambler 400. Nice looking vehicle. The Scrambler 400X. Okay. So, 122 kilometers. I think it's about 100, 110 kilometers only. The 20 was last evening. This is the new breakfast point. It was suggested by a friend. It's nice. This is one thing, if you come late, he will tell you park here and walk there. I hate this part. So we have exchanged bikes, swapping bikes. I am not wearing riding gear, I am just going for a kilometer ride. We have to charge the EV to reach home. So there is one coffee day and charging station about 1 kilometer from here. Hey, this is so tall. How do I push the bike back?
Hey, make this shorter.
It is short. That is at the lower seat height at 805 mm. Huh? No, no, you have to go to the main road and then go to a U-turn and come.
No, now, U-turn is here only.
Here only, here only. I like this switch gear console, Ra. That is new, no? That sliding thing.
It's a little confusing, no?
Yeah. Yeah, this is 185 kilos. How much is that? About 195 only. 10 kilos only, I think. Hey, gear lever is 1 kilometer away from here. See this? It doesn't reach there only. And turning radius is hopeless. Come back and do it. We'll go sit for an hour to charge the. I did this one off. It's So I'm not wearing the riding coat or the gloves, it's all in the car. This is so tiny, it's more nimble, it's more maneuverable. What do you say? It's small. Seating posture is nice in this also, no complaints about that. You don't have to lean too forward. Power delivery is next level. We have to go there. The dash is nice, the analog speedometer with the gear shift indicator and the digital RPM meter. We've been doing 100 at 5,000 RPM, you'd say, 5,500 RPM. Easy to cruise. The seat is hard. It's not as soft as what the Himalayan has. Ride. Even the handlebar is quite wide. Even scrambler's features. No complaints. It's just when you're riding different bikes in the same day, in a few hours' time, you can notice these differences. This bike turns off. I don't know why it turns off every now and then. This turning radius is not that great. This is one thing I don't like. Need better turning radius.
Pretty messy hair. It's okay. Give me the keys.
Are you finished?
Yeah, sit inside. We have come to Coffee Day. Car is charging there. Now I will show you the highlight of the Himalayan.
There's too much.
Hey, what are you saying? The visibility is great.
Yeah,
even during
it's good.
The light. Now, show my phone.
Yeah.
First, what you got to do is open the Royal Enfield app. Full reflection will be there. Bright sunlight. Okay, now we go to navigate. Oh, it's already connected. Let me do one thing. Let me disconnect and show you how to connect it. Since my phone is already connected.
Show how to disconnect also.
No, Wi-Fi only, no. Go to Wi-Fi.
No, the serial number and all.
Yeah, that's what.
You have to give, I think, forget.
Yeah, forget here. And forget this network. So now let's go to Royal Enfield. So the home page, open navigate, and you find this connect button here. So you click connect. We'll just remove this device. Okay, so you come to add a new device. When you say add a new device, you use the triple dash, because it's got the triple dash. You have the triple pod as well. So you select triple dash. You'll find this scanner, which you will have to place here. But one second. Show here.
Oh, here. Okay.
So to get that serial code over there, you will have to hold the joystick towards the right. and you will see that serial code pop up, which needs to be scanned. We will hit okay. It scans too fast, so scanning is done. There is one small glitch. This first digit is 0, but here it is taken as the letter O, which we will just edit. Sorry. And then we'll say connect. So it wants to join. And we are connected. So the motorcycle and iPhone is synced. See that? Your phone, your connected iPhone. So I am on the navigate screen. I will search a destination. Okay, I don't have any safe destinations. I just added Kanyakumari. We will go to get directions here. And this is integrated with Google Maps. So we'll start navigating. And you have it there. You see that? This is for the analog display. Swipe to unlock. Okay, so the navigation has started. The analog display, you will only have directions in the bottom. I will change that to the digital mode. So this is the settings menu where I'll have to go to appearance and screen type. We change that to digital. Okay, now I'll go back home. My phone is connected, local navigation, Kanyakumari, get directions, it is here, we'll start navigation. Please ensure your vehicle station before you unlock the screen. You see that? There it is. So this here is your navigation screen integrated via Google Maps. And all your bike information is below.
Okay.
40% of the screen is used for bike information, 60% for navigation. And me. Now the only issue is, I cannot lock the phone screen. The minute I lock the screen, the navigation is off. See that? It's gone.
Unlock.
So now I'll...
But there is a slight to unlock over here in this.
Yeah, this is swipe to unlock. If I unlock this, it will unlock here on the phone and then again navigation is off there.
So he's giving a lock, but the screen is on.
It is basically more of... my phone has a magnet. It is basically a webcast.
Screen sharing.
Screen sharing process which is happening here. So if you started the navigation on the phone, it will turn off there. Use the button and click once, it will take over on the display, and this has to be in this mode always. So you have a dedicated USB-C type charging socket. You can keep it on charge, buy a phone stand and keep it here. That is all for the navigation tripper. Tripper Dash. I should learn these names. So that is Static, India's largest EV charging station, EV charging network. We had a small photo session. That's why the bikes are back like this next to each other. Yellow Octaja Guru. Now, bike swap, ride back to Bangalore. Oh, you got knuckle protectors and all, as standard. This is really quick car compared to the Himalayan. This is a very peppy motorcycle. Okay, so even this vehicle has done 10,084 kilometers. What happened?
I don't know. It switched off. That was not nice. The Triumph Scrambler 400X comes with a 13-liter tank, about 185 kilos, 40 PS of power. I don't know. Check the details. It's all available online. I'm not bahating all that. I basically am here to enjoy the ride and tell you how it feels while riding. That looks fancy, huh? The gold rims, black paint job with a touch of yellow everywhere. It looks nice, rides nice, comfortable, but it's a long vehicle. See the wheels. So the night is not bad, but yeah, the seat is on the harder side. The bike keeps switching off, I don't know why. When I rev the motorcycle high, the check engine light pops up and it's cut off. I don't know what that is. Otherwise it's nice. Yeah, we need to check how slow can this vehicle go. Oh, let's go to a leveled ground. I'm in 6th gear. We'll see if it can reach, I mean if it can pull from 55. I can't judge 55 exactly in this. Yeah, somewhere there, 50. Ah, not bad. But in city traffic conditions, you need to walk around the gears. The gear lever is placed in a very odd spot, I feel. You need to look around for the gear lever, put your feet under it and then walk around it. And not as smooth as what the Himalayan. That is butter smooth. This, you can feel that clickiness. I still prefer that for the gearbox. Power, peppiness, lightweight, yes. Those are all the advantages. You get this knuckle guards as standard. In this, there's no seat height adjustment. It is fixed at 835 mm. Both motorcycles have their respective manufacturers have loads of accessories for them, for your comfort, for your way of riding. And again, aftermarket accessories are unlimited. You can just keep modifying these bikes the way you like. You want to go out for a weekend ride, you want to tour on the motorcycle, both are capable of doing it for everyday runs in the city. Manageable vibration. Refined engine, so it's okay. But the suspension is on the harder side, both the front and the rear. You can feel that bump coming all the way to you. Any uneven surface is much softer. The ride quality is much better. The right comfort while going on some uneven roads or patches, and the tires and the suspension on the Himalayan would take it much more better. So we are at Kunigal Toll Plaza. What do you think?
Yeah, Himalayan is better.
Same here. There are pros and cons with both bikes, but I would prefer Himalayan over the Scrambler. Nice, it looks nice, it is capable. But comfort always wins. So that much for today's video. Thank you for watching this one. Until next one, take care and stay safe.